So yes, you came down to Melbourne, and like a famous guy from this region, you got the walk-off KO. How does that feel?
Great, man. I'm a fan of a guy from Melbourne, from Australia, named Mark Hunt. So I can do the same as he normally do. So for me, it was great.
Did you know as soon as you hit him that it was over?
Yes, I mean, I know. I'm very confident in my power, either in my kick and my hands. So soon I touch him, I touch his chin, I knew it was out.
Is it a cool experience? Like, obviously he's the hometown guy here, but yet they still appreciate you, still give you applause afterwards. Is that like a cool experience?
That's very cool experience. I'm looking forward to come back here. All week was nice, people nice with me, wishing me good luck, and they didn't boo me down there, so, which is, I love it. I mean, I'm professional. It could be, today was my day, maybe the next day, so it's just in tough, you know. I love the crowd.
Were you waiting for him to open up with that overhand? Because he just looked like he just went way too wide on that punch.
We watched three videos of Justin Taffer, all the same. Wide or left overhand and uppercut. He actually finished three guys like that. So we working all camp. Pull back right hand and straight right hand, which is quicker than overhand. So that's what we did.
So that you credit that knockout to your coaches and the scouting? Really?
I didn't want to do that because he's not going to train me anymore. But yes, my striking coach got the credit on this one. We're working a lot on this. Yes.
You mentioned Mark Hunt. You know, you didn't fight Mark here, but you did fight somebody from that camp. Is it, I guess, a little extra special knowing that you fought someone from such a tough camp?
Yes, yes. I mean, I love those guys. I'm a UFC fighter right now, but I was a UFC fan a couple months ago. So I'm watching Mark Hunt, Tai Tuivasa, even Justin Taffer brought it, the Junior Taffer. So I watch those guys. I know they are brawling. I know what they do. So I'm a fan, and right now I get to fight someone for that camp. Was good to me.
Looking at your performance here today, where would you place yourself in the division right now? Where do you feel that you fit in the heavyweight division?
But I'm still kind of green. I mean, that's what people are gonna say. I'm 6-0, a lot to prove. But I mean, I'm good there. I want to be in that spot. I want to be in that spot. They're gonna overlook me. They wanna underestimate me, and then I'm gonna keep proving them wrong, and keep winning.
I'm sure there's guys that you've been watching for quite some time that you've, you know, thought about and wanted to get in there and fight. Give us a list of some of the guys that you want to challenge yourself with.
Not gonna happen. You're not gonna trick me on that one.
But it's your chance to call them out.
I'm
so
not
easy.
Gonna call people out. No. I
want to
fight anyone.
No.
That's an easy one.
Yeah. No. I mean, honestly, I want to fight. I mean, whatever UFC give it to me, I will fight. I know this. I'm gonna go step by step. I'm 6-0. They sign a lot of guys with the same record as me, so whatever UFC give it to me, I will take it, but no names. So
you just fought in front of 55,000 people. What was the biggest crowd you fought in front of before this?
300 people in Twin River Casino like a couple months ago. January 19, I was talking to my coach. He said, January 19, we are fighting in front of 300 people. I was rushing in to sell tickets and make some money, and now we're fighting it. This was good for us. Being here already was great. And get the job done like that was crazy.
How does it feel compared to fighting in front of 300 people versus 55,000?
That's what I try to do. I try to block everything. My coach keep talking in my ear, dude, this is just another fight. This is just another sparring. Forget about the crowd and focus on your opponent, and you will do good. That's what I try to. I mean, it was hard because I keep looking up. I was like, oh my God. I mean, they're about to. But they were cool. They want to see a show. They want to see a good fight. And that's what I'm every time I step in the cage, that's going to be either get knocked out or going to knock someone out.
So no names. How about when you'd like to fight again?
I want
to
fight December. I'm healthy. I need money. I mean, I'm going right back to work right now. So I need to fight 3 in 3 months. UFC, give me fight, please. I want to fight. I want to do this a full time. This is what I'm born to do.
What do you do when you're not fighting?
I'm a security in the high school. Slap kids around.
They must be very well behaved afterwards.
Yeah, they like me, they love me, they know.
They better.
No, don't have that job anymore.
No.
What did this fight mean for you and your family?
These fights, this is the thing. I keep thinking all week, I get a chance to change a lot of people's lives. My wife, my daughter, my mother, my brothers, and probably help a lot of more people. And this is great for me. I hope they give me the bonus because I'm going to need it and I'm going to use it the right way. And this fight means life change for me.
What's the first thing you're going to do from here with the paycheck and maybe the bonus?
I don't even know. I never get that kind of money, so I have no idea.
Was this a one-fight deal or was this a multi-fight deal?
I got four. I got signed by Contender Series, so I got four fights.
Four fights.
But we're going to, I hope they make their contract better.
Yeah.
Like, you know what I'm talking about?
Of course. Yeah. Yes, cause that contender pay wasn't the biggest.
Yes! Yes, you got it.
Cool. Congratulations.
Thank you very much, guys.
Well done.
Appreciate it, man. Thank you.